does not form too many academies. At the end of the day, everybody wants to have an academy like a home. We'll have too many homes. Let us form few. Let us combine heads. I've been telling the people in clubs. We have 1,000 football clubs in Uganda. I said, why do we have too many clubs? Everybody wants to own a Premier League club, for example. Why don't people combine their time, their resources, and form one powerful club that can do football? Let us form fewer football academies that can compete internationally. We want to bring in people from successful academies in West Africa to tell us how they have done it. They are sending players in Europe, 30, 20, 40 every year. In the top leagues in Europe, how have they done it? But if we have 1,000 academies, how are we going to do that? Each one is struggling to make an academy. Members, it is important. You can have 4 or 5 people come together, form one powerful academy that can be supported by the federation, can be supported better. But if you are 1,000, there's no way we are going to be able. We have friends who have set up academies successful in Senegal. They want to come here and show us how. They want our academies to have relationships with theirs. They want our players to go and stay in the academies if they can sell them to Europe as well. But what relationships do you have? What contracts, what MOUs do you have with such academies? We have to think beyond the usual way. Girls, boys, they put off their shirts, they start running around the pitch and we call it an academy. We will abolish those ones. Will make the work life very difficult for those ones until they die off. That's why we are licensed, that's why we are regulating. We are going to tell the parents that academy is not licensed by us. It's a quack academy. So the first thing, if you cannot survive alone, put your hands together, 3-4 people. You put your resources, you have a better infrastructure, you'll have a better human resource, you'll have better resources, and you'll have an academy. Let us have not too many academies in the same geographical area. You have 10 academies in Ngulu, so what? What are you doing? So how are you going to benefit from the parents? How are we going to encourage the Ngulu city authority to help you when you are 10? That is the strategy. Not a regulation. But we are saying that the regulation will force you to either go up or go sideways. We are not threatening you, but our objective is to make sure that we have proper academies and we are able to generate players in the top leagues in the world. And the reason, the difference, as I conclude, the difference between Uganda players today and the best team in Africa, call it Egypt, call it Senegal, is only they have X-factor players we don't have.